Hi, I'm Vanille, and I'm the voice of Neon in Valorant and Zeri in League of Legends. Home sweet home. Hi, buhay. Hi, grab the spike. I'll show them. Lintik kayo.
Hi! You wanna mess with him? You got to deal with me first. That's my team you're messing with.
Nice to meet you guys.
Let's get to know Vanille Velasquez, the voice behind Neon and Zeri. We ask her about bringing that touch of Pinoy pride to two of Riot's biggest games and her prolific career as a voice actress.
First, I didn't know it was Riot. I had to sign a non-disclosure agreement first. And then that was the only time they told me that it's actually Riot Games. And then my head exploded because I was like, oh my God, Riot Games.
How did you get into voice acting and how long have you been doing it?
I started it as a hobby way before when I was still 10, 11, 12, around that age. But it wasn't until, 2016 when I joined Dubbing Academy on HeroTV. And that's kind of my entry into the local professional voice acting industry. But at the same time, I was already doing it online for indie games, some mobile games here and there, indie animations, things like that.
You better watch out, little brother.
3, 2, 1, action!
All of Vanille's hard work eventually caught the eye of a casting director who was looking for a Filipino voice actor for none other than Riot Games.
I had two auditions for them, and they were both right here in this room where I'm talking to you right now. I recorded both of my auditions at home. They were on a call with me live. They were directing me, but there was no video. It was all audio, so we didn't really see each other until my first recording session. For my recording sessions for League and Valorant, I try to come into my sessions wearing a leather jacket because that made me feel more badass, and these characters are really badass. So that's one thing. Yeah, it helps you get into character. And it's also just really fun to dress up.
But it turns out, getting into character for Neon wasn't difficult at all for Vanille.
Because when they were explaining her personality to me, that this is who she is, this is like this, she's kind of sarcastic sometimes. And I was like, this is kind of like me. So I guess it was easy for me to kind of insert some of myself in her because we were already pretty similar to begin with. Like, I always say one of my favorite lines that I got to do for her was when she said, please stay alive, I hate making new friends, or something like that. And I was like, that is something I would say.
Please stay alive, I hate making new friends.
When I first saw Neon, she looked a little different in early concept arts. So I was just going off of mostly how she was written and what she told me her personality was like. And I really love how they crafted her personality. She's a tough woman. She doesn't take your nonsense. She's confident. You know, she's not a Maria Clara stereotype. You know, she's not mahinhin. And I love that about her. She's a badass.
What's a Maria Clara stereotype? She's sort of the perfect traditional Filipino housewife. Obedient, modest, quiet. Not at all like,
I'll show them! Lintik kayo!
These awesome Tagalog inserts were something that Riot actually encouraged Vanille to do, and they'd often ask for her opinion on many of the voice lines.
For just to clarify, not all of the Tagalog lines are improvised, but I did try to inject some whenever I could. So what happens is when we're recording my script, we do it line by line, and I would usually do all of the first three takes or two takes in English, how it's written, and then maybe I'll improvise a Tagalog on a fourth take. That's usually how it goes, as an option for them. I don't know if you caught the teaser. It was a phone call between Neon and her parents that they released ahead of the trailer. The Tagalog that I said there was not in my script. There was just a note in the script for me to add something in Tagalog, which is really cool for me that they trust me that much to just be like, say something in Tagalog that's appropriate here.
Ay, buhay.
I thought of that line. Initially, they wanted me to translate her very first line in the trailer, home sweet home. But then I was trying to explain to them, we don't really have a Tagalog equivalent to home sweet home. We just say home sweet home. I worked off of the context behind the line. It was kind of a sarcastic home sweet home. She doesn't feel kind of home yet. So that's how the hi buhay came about.
With that one line, fans knew immediately that Riot got this right. Authentic representation for Filipinos in mainstream media is something that Vanille and the rest of the Filipino team behind Neon were very passionate about.
know, I take it as both an honor and a responsibility. I feel like there's this really high expectations about how she's gonna be, and she has to be perfect. So I was feeling that pressure, but I just gave it my all, and I hope that it showed in my performance. I grew up playing video games, and when I was young, it didn't really occur to me why there weren't a lot of Filipino characters in the games that I played. It was only really when I grew older and I started wondering, oh nga no, how come we're not really seen in video games as much as other races? And because, you know, everybody deserves to see themselves in media that they love. So I feel really, really, really happy that the current generation of Filipino gamers will have this. Neon became this because there are actual Filipinos behind her creation. One of her game designers, Ryan, is Filipino himself. A couple other people at Riot were Filipino, who worked on her. And in my opinion, it really shows that there was heart behind her creation. That these are people who were passionate about seeing themselves in media who created her.
But Vanille wasn't done yet. There was someone else who needed that Filipino voice too. Hi! You wanna mess with him? You got to deal with me first.
Like, Zeri is she's very cheerful. She's very happy-go-lucky. You know, she's always, like, a lot of her lines are very, like, bubbly and happy and high-pitched and, you know, all that stuff. But on the other hand, Neon, her humor is so dry. She's so sarcastic. She's, like, the opposite of Zeri. So what I did with their voices is Zeri's voice is on the higher side, just like her personality, and Neon's voice is on the lower end naman of my voice. My younger brother has been the biggest fan of League of Legends since I was a kid, since we were both kids, actually. It's like my life has been like giving me little hints about League of Legends, and then I had no idea that they were actually hints that I was gonna be a part of it someday until almost a decade later.
How did it feel knowing that you were going to voice a character from Zaun, a city that is now very well known thanks to Arcane?
I am a huge fan of Arcane. I just say that. Yeah, and I was fangirling to the devs about it. When they showed me a rough draft of Zeri's trailer in one of my sessions, and it was like, oh my god, that's Zaun. But it was a fangirl moment for me because I've just seen Arcane, and I was like, oh my god, it's my character, she's in Zaun. But just to clarify, I have no idea if there are any plans for Zeri to be in Arcane or anything like that, but that would be super cool.
After jumping into Neon's shoes and giving Zeri her spark, then came another challenge for Vanille: keeping quiet for several months about her biggest break yet.
It's so funny because working on this the past few months, I was like, I can't wait to be able to tell everybody about this. And then when that week came, when I knew the trailer was gonna come, the days before, I was just sleeping all day because I was so nervous about it. Oh my god, I was like, I've been waiting for this, pero parang ngayon na malapit na siya, parang ayoko na. I'm so scared because everything is going to change, and I don't know how everything is going to change.
I just heard the teaser that I recorded for Neon on Valorant's Instagram story, and I don't know why I'm crying. I'm getting so nervous about it. Like, a lot of things are going to change for me.
That was the first time I heard them, and it was really, really, really insane, the feeling of that. And watching everybody react to how she said, lintik kayo. It was so fun seeing what everybody was saying. And it was so hard not being able to tell them that that was me.
And Vanille was right. Everything did change for her in the best way possible.
It was so scary. Like, every few minutes I would look at my notifications. They're just blowing up. I couldn't keep up with my messages. It was insane. It was a roller coaster. Most of the responses I've been getting, overwhelming majority of them have been super positive. And I'm really grateful. And I love seeing how much Neon and Zeri mean to these Filipino fans of League and Valorant. And yeah, they just remind me of why I do my job.
With Vanille's newfound recognition, she is definitely dreaming bigger. And she's got some advice for those who hope to get that same big break someday.
I don't want to just be like, chase your dreams without saying anything actually concrete to back that up, because you have to put in the work as well. Riot didn't just contact me out of nowhere with zero experience. I earned my experience. I've worked on other video games before, and even if they're just indie games, it's not just about dreaming and the passion. You have to put in the work.
For all the praise Vanille is getting, however, there is one person who might not be too happy about Vanille as Neon and Zeri.
You know, I think my brother thinks it's so weird. I think I might have ruined the game for him, because now he's going to hear his sister all the time. He might have to mute the voices of the agents now.
Sorry, Vanille's brother. It is for the greater good, because Vanille is awesome. Marami salamat, Vanille. If you think she's awesome too, like, comment, and subscribe, and let us know who else you'd like to see featured right here on One Esports.